Hello everybody and welcome back to another video, and oh boy, what have I gotten myself into this time? Well, this is going to be another one of those Weeb OS focused videos, kind of like the Ubuntu video that, well, we did a couple videos on that, and you guys really seemed to like those. I got a few comments on both of those videos recommending Moebuntu to me, which, what differentiates this from Ubuntu is this is not an entire operating system, but it's rather a set of themes and visual enhancements, if you want to call them that. I guess that's very subjective, that you can make to your existing install of Ubuntu Linux to Weebify it a little bit. And this does a lot more than Ubuntu does. It really, as you can see here, let's say enhances, again, very subjective, it enhances the visual style and, you know, modifies the dock, it modifies the menu bar, it just really takes effect across the entire system. So, yeah. The installation tutorial for 2204, which is the version of Ubuntu that we're running here, is entirely in Japanese. Now, there's two ways of doing this. The first option is the manual method, which is going by this tutorial right here. It's very detailed, it tells you how to do everything. Luckily, there is a setup helper script available as well that makes the process much easier, and we're gonna go this route for this video just to really show you how to get everything installed in the simplest way possible. This page is also in Japanese, but we really only have to go to this link if you want to get the Japanese version of the script, or if we scroll down here, there is an English version right here. They're both hosted over on GitHub, and this is it right here. You just want to scroll down to the releases area and download this file right here. Now, it's worth noting that depending on which version of Ubuntu you have installed, the setup process will be a little bit different, and they've got guides here for 2204 all the way down to 1804. But they've also got some additional stuff on this website. They really went all out with this. So Moebuntu Studio is moenizing, as they say on the website here, Ubuntu Studio. So if you go to the how-to here, this is specifically for version 12.04, which is not the latest version of Ubuntu Studio, so I suspect this hasn't been updated in a while. But yeah, they've got that. They've got themes, different themes available. Now, the script that we will run here momentarily will give you the option of picking different color themes, but you could also download them manually here. They also have icon themes, they've got sound themes, different sound themes, because yes, this changes the sounds of the system as well. Notably, they've got wallpapers available as well. So if you wanted to, you know, moenize your wallpaper as well. And then this is my favorite thing down here. They've got, like, logos and stuff for other Linux distros that they've moenized or weebified. So you've got Pink Hat here for Red Hat. You've got Modora. You've got Vimo Linux, which is for Vine Linux, which Vine Linux and this one right here, these are both Japanese Linux distros, which I had not heard of before, but they do exist. And then you've got Mopi Linux for Puppy Linux, which is like, oh my god, it's just, god, it's just too good. But yeah, so that's a little tour of the website. Let's go ahead and open up our file browser here. We'll go to downloads, and you can see I've downloaded one of the wallpapers here. We will apply that in a minute here, but we've got the scripts file here. We're going to open this up and extract everything. We'll just extract it to downloads. That's fine. We'll show the files. And there we go. So we'll get out of this. And from here, you want to find the MoSet file. Right click on this and go to Run as Program. It'll open up Terminal. And this is where you do everything. All those other scripts are just run from here. So first, you want to go with option one, which says Do First, all the base settings. So we'll do that. You enter in your password. And it starts downloading a few things, installing a couple packages. And it opens up the Extension Manager. Now, it will ask you from here that you need to do a couple of things in the extension manager. First, get out of the what's new thing, and it tells you to go to the browse tab, search for user themes, install it, and then you have to enable it under user install extension. So we'll go to browse, search for user theme, and install this here. And at this point, the script kind of, like, there's no press any key to continue thing showing up. I think you just have to hit Control C to get out of it, and then we got to go back into it. And next up is applying the theme color that you want. So you got a few different, more than a few different colors to choose from here. Before you do that though, what you'll want to do is install GNOME Tweaks, if you don't already have it installed, which is not something that the script here will install for you. So, we're going to open up another terminal window, and we're going to run sudo apt install GNOME Tweaks. This is required for the theme to take effect on the dock, and the menu bar will not work without it. So we've got that installed, we'll close out of that. And let's just apply the pink theme, since that's the default one that's kind of showcased on the website. So we'll do that, enter our password, and it will install some new packages, go through everything automatically for you. Okay, so I was wondering about this because I was testing this off camera and I didn't have GNOME Tweaks installed before running the script. And it looks like it, even when you have it installed, it still does not automatically apply the dock and menu bar theme, at least the first time that you apply the theme. So I'll show you how to do that in a minute here. But we've got a few other options. It asks you if you want to change the login screen. We'll say yes. And now you get to choose if you want the login picture. We'll say yes. And now we hit any key and we're done. So to apply the theme for the dock and menu bar, you want to open up GNOME Tweaks. So we'll just search for tweaks here. And we go in here, you want to go to appearance, and you want to change shell to Moebuntu 16. And there you go, it's supplied, and it is definitely very pink across the entire system. So yeah, but we're not done yet. Oh no, we're not, because we have to now apply the icons. So let's go ahead with number 12 here. Now you see they also have options to remove everything. So if you want to get rid of the themes, you want to get rid of the icons, they've got the same thing for the wallpaper and the sounds over here, which is very nice if you just want to get like one aspect of this. Like say you just want the icons and nothing else, you can just run this script, go to option 12 here, and you'll just get the icons if you don't do anything else. And there you go, it's just applied. So if we go into the file browser here and we go to like the home folder, you can see we got all new icons. Isn't that amazing? Yeah, and you also see the window controls change as well. So they kind of got like a Mac OS thing going on with the traffic light colors, but they're in the shape of a heart. So yeah, there's that for you. And so that's the icons, that's this entire side here. We will come back and take a look at some of these other themes in a moment here. But next up is the spinner, which is just referring to the boot screen animation. So we'll go with option 14 and we'll say, yes, we want to apply the Moebuntu screen image, and it's done. So next up is the wallpaper, which it does give you the option of dragging and dropping a wallpaper in here. You could obviously just apply it yourself by going into the settings panel and just changing your wallpaper. But if I wanted to, I could go into the file browser here and go to this one that I downloaded and just drag it in here. If you don't do that, it will set it to a default one, which is this one right here. We're going to run that through again, and we'll just drag and drop this wallpaper here. And we'll not open it up. We'll hit enter here if I get back in the terminal. Next up is Firefox, because yes, believe it or not, they do have a custom theme for Mozilla Firefox, but for it to be applied properly, you have to install the deb package instead of the default snap package that is installed, at least in Ubuntu 22.04 here. So if you run option 18, it will get rid of the snap package, replace it with the deb package, and we get this system program problem detected. I wonder if it's just because we removed the Firefox package. Okay, crash report is ready. Sorry, the application add apt repository has stopped unexpectedly. Hey, we had to have something go wrong in an MJD video. Unable to find server at api.launchpad.net. Cannot install Firefox, persistent network error. Am I like offline or something? I can't even get the snap package back. What happened? Oh, okay. Apparently we're offline somehow. How on earth did that happen? Okay, because the adapter here in the VM is on. Well, that would make sense. Okay, there we go. That was odd. It just disconnected from the network for some reason. Okay, let's try this again. There we go. That's better. There it is. So yes, it changes the icon as well. And now we've got the wonderful pink theme applied across Firefox as well. So, which, oh boy, that doesn't really look good. Yeah, so it has some it has some trouble here. Yeah, something with the window manager, I guess. Oh gosh, that is not supposed to happen. But yeah, so there's Firefox, and this theme I believe will change when we apply. And let's just go ahead and apply like the blue theme here. So we'll go ahead and do option three. I think out of all of these, especially with the background that we have, the red theme is going to look really nice. Yes, we want to change login screen. Yes, we want to do this, hitting a key. Okay, so it did not apply. That's interesting. It did apply to Firefox and to the Windows here, but not to the dock and the menu bar. Though I think the system, once you restart, I believe that's what I did when I was testing this off camera. When you restart, it will then, when you run through and change the theme from the script, it will also apply to the menu bar and the dock. So let's go ahead and restart, and I can show you the boot screen as well. So there it is, very pink. There aren't different variations of the boot screen, there's just one, and there's the logo down there. And I have it set to login automatically, so that's why we didn't see the login screen. But if I log out here, I'll show you what that looks like. It's also very pink. And because we have the blue theme applied, it's got blue highlights going on, so we'll put in my password, super secure. I'm sure you'll never be able to guess what that is. So now let me apply, let's go with the red theme because I think that one would look the nicest with the background that we have. So we'll do that. It has changed the window color and everything. We still have to go through and get, yes, login screen, yes, hit any key. Okay, so it did not apply to the menu bar and the dock. That's interesting because it worked before off camera. After restarting the system. So yeah, okay, so if it doesn't apply automatically, you'll have to open up GNOME tweaks, go to appearance, and change the shell to whatever Mo theme that corresponds to the theme for everything else. So red, now everything's red. And yeah, I think it looks pretty nice with this background. Yeah, this one definitely is my favorite. With the background, of course, it doesn't really fit in super well. And last but not least, we've got the sound pack here, which you've got four different ones to choose from. We'll just go with the first one here and we'll do that. Very, very simple. And now you've got the sounds, if you have sounds enabled. Actually, I can just play the sound files if we go to the directory where they're stored. It's going to be in USR, share, and then sounds here. And this is the one that we got. So, you go to stereo. So, there you go. That's the button press sound, button toggle off. System ready. So, yeah, the audio quality, too, you can kind of hear, isn't like the greatest. And the sounds are like, the sounds are kind of long as well. So, you know, if you don't want to hear that every time you log in, you might want to, you know, not use the sound packs or just disable this particular sound. But yeah, so there's the error sound. And one other thing that I almost forgot is fonts, because there are fonts available. It's not something you can install from the script here, but if we go to this page, and this is that text tutorial that I was mentioning earlier, you have to go to this site, at least to get the links here. We're going to get the kawaii font, because that is a thing. So we go here, and you scroll way down here to this link. This is the download. And we'll double-click on it and install it. So there's the... There's the font. So it's named Kawaii Handwriting. And then we just got to go back to the Tweaks program and go to fonts, and then you change the interface text to, yeah, there it is. So we're going to get, let's do this one here, the bold and italicized one, and then document text. Oh yeah, we definitely want to change that to maybe regular. We'll select that. We'll change this one here, the monospace text, to bold maybe. Legacy window titles, we'll change that to the italicized regular one. And yeah, so we can up the scaling factor a little bit too if you want to make this like super obnoxious. Oh yeah, there there we go. That's what I'm talking about. So yeah, that's the oh my, this was something I did not do off camera. Holy cow. So maybe we want to bring this down a little bit. I can't even freaking see the... Oh, I think that it like maxes out. Oh yeah, I typed in 10. That wasn't even 10. That was 3, which is what it maxes out as. So let's bump it down just to 1 here. And there we go. Maybe we'll bump it to 2. Yeah, there you go. That is the, or those are rather, the Moebuntu themes for Ubuntu Linux. I think this is absolutely hilarious. And you know, I'm kind of thinking, like, this theme, just the blue theme for the Windows and the menu bar and the dock is actually pretty nice on its own. Like, if you didn't want anything else, if you have no interest in the wallpapers or the sounds or any of the other Weeb stuff, or the Moification, I should say, this might interest you just for the color themes alone. Although you do have the, I almost forgot, you do have the window controls. So I guess you'd have to be okay with that. Of course, there are plenty of other ways of modifying and theming Ubuntu. This is certainly one of them, and it is rather interesting. And I got a bunch of people recommending this to me in the comments section of those two other videos, I was like, yeah, we should probably take a look at it. So there it is. There's Moebuntu in all of its glory. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up, get subscribed, all that good stuff. And as always, I want to thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.